Hi all, so welcome to this channel, and in this video session I'll discuss in-out parameters in the SQL stored procedure in IBM IS400. So basically I'll discuss input parameters, output and in-out both. That is a parameter which is either input or output both. So let's move towards the demo. I created some examples to show you this thing. So you can see this is stored procedure stored 33, where I'm taking three parameters as an input or output. Basically two are input parameters and the third one is the output parameter. So you can see, you can easily identify the input and output parameters with the in or out keyword used as a prefix and then the parameter name, that is in p_name and then the character data type and length. So you can see this is an input parameter of character 20 length, name p_name, then another input parameter p_gender, character 1 length, then you can see the last one, the output parameter out success char 1. So these are the parameters which are coming as input and then going back as an output to the caller. And here you can see the specific name. So a specific name is something which is you can say the object name. Whenever we create a stored procedure, a program type object gets created, so that's name is stored 33. So this is always unique for a stored procedure and within a schema. So if in case there are two procedure named same like this, but the specific name must be different, that is always unique within a schema. Now here comes the body section, begin and end. In between the body, you can see that I have declared the SQL state variable which is of 5 length character, and I provided the default value as blank. And you can see I also declared SQL code integer, default value 0. So here in SQL RPG we do not need to declare these two variables, so compiler in itself defines them, but here we need to explicitly define these SQL state and SQL code in the SQL stored procedure in IBM I. And now you can see I'm inserting the data into this table pf8_t, name comma gender, values p_name and p_gender. Whatever values I am receiving as an input parameter, I am inserting it into the table, and then I am checking if SQL code is 0, then set success equals to 1. Means if it is 0, means this row gets inserted successfully, then we are setting the success, that is an out parameter, to 1. Means it's success, the row has been inserted. If it is not, if it fails, SQL code is something else, then it sets the success as 0, means it's not inserted, and end if. So if and end if and end. So let's compile this. So for compilation, I'll use the run SQL stm command. Stored proc is the source physical file. This is the library, and this one is the member. Just commitment control and star none, and debug view is star source. You can see stored 33. This object gets created. If I do dsppgm on this, you'll see the module also gets created, but that was created in Qtem and then deleted. Now I can also check this from qsys 2.sysprox where specific name is stored 33. So you can see the external name is ed class 1/this 233. So this is basically the program which gets called in this library when we execute this procedure. Now we can check this in sysparams 2. So you can see there are 3 entries here, and now I'll be seeing what are all those parameters, input parameter, and this one is the output parameter. And you can also check the data type and the length assigned to them. Now let's call this procedure. Either you can call it from the command line or from the SQL session. So just call stored. So let me first show you the data. PF8 underscore d, this one name 4. So let me debug this first. grdbg stored 33. Let's wait for a few seconds. Just set the breakpoint. STSQL call stored 33. We need to pass the name. Let's say I'm passing name XYZ, comma gender as male, let's say. And I need to pass the output parameter, so I cannot basically I need a variable which can receive the value. So if let me pass, like if I cannot pass any data from here, because that's an output parameter, that's not an input parameter. So if I pass like a parameter marker, it will not again be used. Use a parameter marker or null, not valid. I cannot pass null, you can see. I cannot pass any value from here. So how can I call it from STSQL then? So I need a global variable which can store the value which is coming back to the caller. So we are calling from here. So let's create a variable. Let's say I'm creating a variable of named success of length char 1. Let's provide the default value to null. The variable this was created. So if you check this work object success, so you can see our service program object gets created. strsql. Now if I see the data, select success from sys ibm dot sys dummy 1. So you can see it's by default null. Now let's call that stored procedure, call stored 33, this one. So here I need to pass that global variable which can receive the output value. Now you can see we are able to call this. So p underscore name is this, p underscore gender is this. This one is the success, so it's null because it is by default null. Just take F10, SQL state is set to blank zeros. SQL code is zero. Now this was inserted, the row gets inserted which we have passed. name x y z m. So the SQL code here is 0. So if SQL code is 0, then set success, which was null, so it gets set to 1 and the call statement is complete. Now if I want to see the data which we received as an output, select success. So you can see now it's 1. Earlier it was null, now it's 1. So let's set the success again to its default value, null. Set success, so we can set it to null, but let's set to default value. So default is again null, so we'll basically setting to null. Now the same way, this was an output parameter. Let me show you the in out parameter as well. So here you can see this store 34 procedure. So the procedure 33 and 34 are same, there is no difference at all, except the one thing, the parameter, this parameter is in out now. So either it can receive the values or it can also output the values. So let's create this. Run SQL STM stored proc. Stored 34. Debug view as source. So you can see the stored 34 gets created successfully. Now we need to call stored 34 name ABC, let's say then gender F. Let's now here again, this is an input output parameter, so it can even receive an input and we can pass an output. So we need to pass a, when we call it from the SQL RPGLE, we need to pass a variable which will basically gives input as well as receive that output, whatever coming from the caller called stored procedure. But here we need to see the output actually, or the input would be given to this using that variable. So here we need a variable. So the variable here in SQL would be global variable. So we have already created one SQL variable success. So let's call that. So you can see the call statement is complete. Let's see, you can see the row gets inserted. Now let's have a look at the global variable which is received as an in out parameter, which was set to null. So you can see it's now 1. So if I set it to set success to 0, let's say, so it's set to 0. If I again insert 0, now check it again. So you can see again the row gets inserted, its output is 1. So you can see the row gets inserted successfully. So this way you can create an SQL stored procedure in IBM IS-400 having in out or in out parameters. So that's all in this video. Thank you and have a nice time.